Well, obviously, this is everything that that we've worked an entire year for, and that's first and foremost. This is something that our guys, you know, have put on as an objective, and we got to make sure that we are not denied nor distracted by all the different things. And there's a lot of things, not just things with me, but with all of our guys. I mean, we've said that on Sunday night. Let's get rid of all the things you got to be able to handle this week based on Sunday and Monday. And when Tuesday comes and practice starts, we got to be ready to roll. So obviously Houston's a great football team. This is, to me, as well balanced a football team as we've played all year, offense, defense, and special teams. It doesn't, you know, you guys can look at the stats and see that stuff. As complete a team, I think, you know, as we've played all year. And that's why it's going to be huge. You know, this is another opportunity for our seniors, not just, I always say our seniors, but it's another incredible opportunity for our entire football team and program to play in front of an incredible crowd, a student section, you know, with an opportunity to win a championship at home. That those things obviously don't come around all that often, and to do it actually at home, obviously there aren't a whole lot of conferences that that have that. You know, but we have got a challenge. Obviously, 11-1 Houston team that, you know, lost game one and has run off 11 straight. So it's going to be an incredible challenge. And with a coach, I think, to be honest with you, I don't think anybody's done as good a job all year as Dana Holgorsen has. And I don't know where everybody had him picked and ranked to start the season, but what they have done this year and watch them grow as a football team and program, you know, just off your cross games is really, really, really impressive. So, you know, we got to make sure, no matter what, you know, every one of our kids and every one of our coaches understand that this is what we've worked an entire year for. And nothing can keep us from doing what we need to do. And that has a lot to do with not just playing on Saturday, but it has even more to do with the preparation that that it takes to win a championship.
They are extremely aggressive, especially on defense. How do you game plan for a team that you know is going to come after you every snap?
Well, I mean, obviously the offensive guys have to do a great job of that. It's hard to simulate at times. You know, it's kind of like, you know, when you're playing some of those offenses, like go back to Navy, and it's hard to simulate, you know, the speed of how you do things and how they do things. It's similar, I think, for them defensively. It's hard sometimes to simulate the speed and the aggressiveness of what they do, especially with their guys up front. So it's a challenge. And, you know, we've seen it all year, kind of watching, not knowing that this is what it was going to get to. I don't know that the offensive guys get to see their defense that often because they don't watch those crossover games. But I know being in the defense, obviously a lot more, we were able to see a lot of that, you know, their aggressiveness and see what they've done all year. So it's a challenge. And, you know, we always talk about the other way around when, you know, you're facing a tempo team or you're facing the UCS that throw the ball down the field and go mock speed, and you're facing a Navy team that runs the option. Well, it's the same way the other side. Sometimes it's really difficult to prepare for something that you probably haven't seen as much all year, and it's really just the speed and the aggressiveness of it. So they'll throw a lot on our guys. I mean, we've got to give the looks, and that scout crew's got to try to simulate as best they possibly can so those guys can feel what it's really like.
You've talked all year about blocking out the noise, controlling what you can control. When it goes from something like rankings to job carousel and it's more on you specifically, does that change how you handle it individually?
No, I mean, I don't say I do a lot of things really good, but one thing I like to think I do pretty well is keep my head down and not get into all the other stuff. And, you know, I don't look at my phone. I don't read a whole bunch. So for me, I don't think it's as big a deal. But I know, you know, obviously it's not about me. It's about the 18 to 22-year-olds. It's about, you know, everybody in our program. So we obviously are aware of all the different things on everybody's plate, you know. But we got to have enough maturity. We got to have enough respect for what it is that we've all done, you know, and especially what these seniors have done, to not allow it to be a distraction to anything that we do.
Do you address that distraction with the team this week? Say, hey, you're focused on this game.
Yeah, you know, normally we don't do a whole bunch of that. I think that's one of those things that I, you know, maybe I don't do a great job of. You know, I rely upon the leadership of those guys and what it is that they've done. You know, we've got enough trust, respect, and love within our walls. And I say the locker room, but within our walls, that a lot of times, you know, we don't deal with those things on the outside. If we feel like we need to, then we will. You know, just like if a kid has an issue, you don't want him to let it fester. And, you know, but I can promise you there's enough trust, respect, and love in this program that, you know, we all know what we're headed for. We all know what we need to do.
A class of 33 seniors, what does it mean to have that opportunity to come back for one final time for a conference championship?
It's an awesome feeling. I'm so happy for those guys. When you had that last senior day, you said this is our last guaranteed opportunity, and we always kind of use those terms, kind of like we say with senior, this is your last guaranteed opportunity to play in a game of college football. And we all know there are probably more games, and when you played that last game, you were hoping maybe you would have another home game, but we always refer to it as the last guaranteed opportunities. Well, this is the last opportunity for these guys to play in front of that home crowd, to play in front of that student section and in the Nippert Stadium. So I'm happy, I'm excited for them. Obviously we love having it at home, but it means a little bit more. I know that just from what those guys have been through and where they were 5 years ago. So it's another great opportunity.
Would you mind addressing the Notre Dame speculation?
Yeah, and I don't know what there is to address. I mean, like I said, for a guy that keeps his head down and very rarely ever answers his phone or does anything like that, I don't talk to a whole lot of people. So there is nothing. That's the crazy thing. It's all, you know, whatever is being said out there and different things. So there is no speculation. You know, is the job open? I guess it is, but I wouldn't know if somebody didn't tell me. And it's the same way I am with rankings. It's the same way I am with, you know, unfortunately a lot of other things, with exception to recruiting, that I don't pay a whole lot of attention to. So I understand that, you know, most importantly, all I care about are the guys that sit in these seats, to be honest with you, to make sure that they know what's most important to all of us, and, you know, to make sure we've all got to find ways to keep our minds focused on the things that we've got to be able to do, because I'm not the only guy that's got things swirling around in their head. You know, we've got plenty of guys that have opportunities to go to the NFL. You know, we've got plenty of guys that have opportunities to make decisions, you know, whether to come back. We got seniors that, you know, there's this COVID year hanging over everybody's heads that, you know, they've got decisions to make. So we've all got things, and what these guys have done a phenomenal job all year of is finding ways to not allow that to affect how we handle our business. And I mean that together. We haven't always been perfect, but I mean the things that we do within that locker room or on that football field. Like I said, we rely a lot on the trust, respect, and love we have for one another.
Do you have any thoughts about how college football generally might address this annual craziness?
Yeah, I got some thoughts. I don't know that this is the time or the place for it, but it's an ever-changing world. That's the tough thing. And some people would point it at, well, early signing or transfer. It's a lot of things. And you know, our job as coaches is to continue to make this game better. And you know, we've got to make sure within the off season we make this game better. I've got some things that I want to, you know, talk about as far as how the game is played, you know, with what we're allowing and where we're moving to as a game of football. And I think as coaches, we need to address it where our game is going to in the midst of, you know, 18 to 22 year olds, a college student athlete, as opposed to, is it moving a little bit more towards what the NFL is? But those are things for the offseason.
You talked the other day about three straight conference titles. What has been the differentiator for this program that you've been able to sustain that success?
I really do believe it's you know, that complementary all three phases. It's, you know, we've continued to grow. And I'm not saying we were, you know, great in any one phase, you know, 3 years ago, but I think what we have done is we have caught up and been able in all three phases of the game find ways to win. And I think that's what it comes down to. I mean, you see it every week. I don't watch a whole lot of college football. Last weekend, I probably the first time in a while that I've watched college football. That's the nice thing about playing on a Friday. And it just reminds you that it's very difficult to win. It's very difficult, to sustain what it is that you're doing. And the only way I believe that we've been able to do that is because we have balance in what we do. You know, at times we haven't played well defensively. A couple years ago at ECU, and our offense picked it up, and we found a way to make a play at the end of the game and win a game. And, you know, and other times we've, you know, had to kick field goals in the last plays of the game a couple years ago, where, you know, the other way around, maybe the offense hasn't played well and all of a sudden the defense gets turnovers and does some things. So if I really looked at it over the last 3 years, I'd say our ability to play complementary football, our ability to play all three phases, trust, respect each other, and find ways to win.
I know you don't, you know, like the P5, G5 stuff, but at a program like this, what's the biggest challenge to that, to being able to, you know, not have a gimmick offense or, you know, be strong on one side, to be able to play be a complete team?
Well, I still think it starts up front. And I mean, really the top 10 programs, when you really look at them, yes, they've got great athletes, yes, they do, but I think they have the ability, you know, on both sides of the ball, to be able to, at times, really control the football game, you know, rely upon those guys. And no matter what, I don't think it changes. It's still about the ability to have those guys up front that, you know, can make a big difference in what it is that you're doing.
How much are they like you and the level of aggression that you play with? Is it different the way that they do it, or are there similarities?
No, I think there are some. I think that, you know, there are different schemes defensively. But I think, you know, what I have seen, you know, even from ECU last week, I think it's a very aggressive defense. And I think that we're going to see the same thing, different, you know, maybe a little, obviously with more of a four-man front and a little bit of different ways in which they are aggressive by nature. But I think, you know, what you're starting to see is maybe I'm not saying a transformation, but, you know, whether it's in the league or not, of just, you know, the defenses that are becoming more aggressive, as opposed to, you know, where, as these offenses have, to me, have progressed and become really innovative in the last 6, 7, 8 years, you know, where I think the defenses were a little bit more passive. And I think what we're seeing, particularly in our league, is some defenses that are becoming much more aggressive. And it's, you know, a bigger factor, I think, than what maybe it was 5 years ago.
Is that reflective across the sport? I think if you look at the four or five teams that are in the top five, all of them are in the top 10, 11 in defense.
You know what? It's the stats I don't usually look at till the end of the year. So
I just told you.
I appreciate that. That's really good. I guess I didn't think about it beforehand. You always say when it comes to the playoffs in the NFL, about when college football is over and the playoffs kick in, it's about the only time I would be aware of what's going on as much in the NFL. And you always hear about it late in the year. You know, those teams that can run the football and those defenses that are in the top three or four of the league are the ones that are still playing. Maybe there's something to that. I don't know. I hate to say Coach Saban said it two years ago, which was a kind of a dagger when he said it, that, you know, obviously the offenses are far above what defenses are, and good offenses can't stop, you know, really good, or good defenses, you know, don't have as much of a chance against really good offenses. So I don't know. Maybe there's some balance coming back to what it is that we're doing.
You obviously wouldn't have known about the COVID year and added year of eligibility, but was there a deliberate effort to get old? You know, that's another thing that people talk about, and that good teams have.
I don't know that we had to get old. We've got some older guys. We got some guys that have been here for a while. But I think as you look across, you know, older teams have a chance. You know, I'm not saying always a greater chance. I mean, youth is still what everybody's looking for too, right? But I think the maturity of what you got when you've got that deeper group, guys have been there for 4 and 5 years, I think it does really help you. But like anything, there's got to be a balance to what it is you're doing. You know, if you're playing with, you know, 35, 18-year-olds, you could have a problem. But if you're playing with, you know, 35, you know, 22-year-olds, I mean, maybe you don't have some of that youth and some of the different things that they bring as well. So it comes back to balance.
Any more questions?
Yeah, if I may hop in before you take off. You've been talking all year long about just taking care of your business and winning games and playing the best ball game of the year. You win Saturday, do you think this team has done enough to be a college football playoff team?
They aren't calling me. They're probably not, after the game, no matter what happens, going to call and ask me what I think. So I just kind of always try to keep my opinions to myself. You know, our job is to go out there and play our best game on Saturday. And if we do that, and it's good enough, then we'll be in the spot that we should be. If we don't do that, or we do that, and it's not good enough, I mean, there's nothing else that I can do about it. But That's another one of those things that you just don't have any control over, and you don't allow yourself to worry about it. And you know, we leave that to the higher ups and the people that can worry about that. But you know, anything beyond 4 o'clock on Saturday is probably not something I'm spending a whole lot of time worrying a whole bunch about.
I think you told me after the Notre Dame game, you thought it was one of the best teams in the country. So kind of late, that you still feel like you're one of the best teams.
Yeah, I mean, we're 12-0. You know, we found a way to win, whether everybody believes it was pretty or not. And there's one left, one other team that's undefeated in college football. So, yeah, I mean, you know, I don't. Whatever anybody else says, like I said, there's a lot of opinions out there. It's amazing the amount of different ones that you can get based on who you ask. And, you know, that's why they don't usually call and ask us what we really think about and what it is that they're going to make decisions on.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks.
Thank you.